إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. قال الله تعالى: إنا أعطيناك الكوثر، إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. إنا أعطيناك الكوثر. Indeed, we have given you the kawthar. In the tafsir, the kawthar is the hawd, the pool that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم will be given on the day of judgment, the pool where he will receive his ummah. Receiving his ummah to drink from this pool, and thereafter accepting their shafa'ah for those who are deserving of shafa'ah, of intercession. For all of the prophets had a dua, and they used their dua in this life. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his dua, his supplication, he left it for his ummah. To supplicate for his ummah on yawm al-qiyamah, for those who are destined for the hellfire, to be supplicated for to be coming out of the hellfire, or to not even reach the hellfire in the first instance, because of the shafa'at of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say to his sahaba, to his companions, meet me at the hawd, meet me at this pool. طوله شهر, its distance, its length is 1 month's journey. وَعَرْضُهُ شَهْر, and its width is 1 month's journey. مَاءُهُ أَشَدُّ بَيَاضًا مِنَ اللَّبَنِ, its drink, its water, it is extremely white, whiter than milk. وَأَحْلَى مِنَ الْعَسَلِ, and sweeter than honey. وَآنِيَتُهُ كَنُجُومِ السَّمَاءِ, and its cups as like the stars in the sky. And some of the scholars said regarding this, in terms of its brightness, and in terms of its, and some of them said in terms of its vast number. So whoever drinks from it, من شرب منه شربة لم يضمأ بعدها أبدا, whoever drinks from it, this pool which has been reserved for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his ummah, and he will say, Ummati, Ummati, my nation or my people, my nation. And they will come. And how will he recognize them? He will recognize them from the marks of wudu that are on their foreheads and on their sides. Just like the horse that you see, the whiteness on their legs or their forehead. You see the whiteness? Just like that, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم described that it would be like غُرَّ الْمُحَجَّلِينَ, they will come on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ with the marks of wudu on them. So glad tidings, O Ummat Muhammad, O Muslims, O believers, glad tidings when you do the wudu, when you do the ablution. This is greatness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is cleanliness. And this is also reward for you and me. يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, this is how the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم would recognize you and me, by the marks of wudu. So enjoy the wudu and do it according to the sunnah by saying Bismillah and beginning that which the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم did. beginning the wudu and doing it correctly and not to cheat in it. This is where salvation lies. And people might think, oh, it's only wudu. It's not only wudu. This is your reason for salvation, for you to be recognized by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on Yawm al-Qiyamah, Ummati, Ummati. And they will come. So guard the wudu and guard the prayers. For the wudu is a condition from the conditions of the salah. And do it according to the sunnah. And not only taharatul badan is important, but taharatul hissiyya wal ma'nawiyya, even the purification, which is the purification of your aqeedah, which is the purification of your belief, far away from shirk, far away from bid'ah, far away from that which displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the believers will come, and he will say, Ummati, Ummati. And they will drink from the pool, and when they drink, they will never feel thirsty again. Never feel thirsty again. And there will be those who changed. And it will be said, Suhqan, Suhqan, be off, be off. And the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam will inquire regarding that, and it will be told to him, you do not know what they have changed after me. The great scholar, Sheikh Abdul Aziz bin Baz, rahimullah, said, from the reasons of being rejected is that you change the deen, bid'ah. Innovation is from the reasons to be rejected. Sheikh Abdul Aziz bin Baz, rahimullah, mentioned this in his explanation of Al-Aqidah Al-Wasatiyah. He said, from the reason to be rejected is you change the sunnah to bid'ah. People think they're doing good, but they are rejected. Because why? They changed after the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And from those who changed are those who left the deen. And those who brought new things to the religion. So, إِنَّا أَعْطَيْنَاكَ الْكَوْثَرِ. This was said to the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. When the mushrikun, they were looking at the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam after a difficult period that he went through. And the night, his son Abdullah passed away. And no doubt anyone who loses a son, anyone who loses a daughter, anyone who loses a family member, they feel sorrow and they feel sadness. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, no doubt, he was sad and he felt sorrow because he said it. He said, "Inna al-ayn la tadma." Indeed, the eyes shed tears. Wa inna al-qalb la yahzan. And the hearts are softened and sad, saddened. وَمَا نَقُولُ إِلَّا مَا يُرْضِ اللَّهِ. And we do not say except that which pleases Allah. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. To Allah we belong, and to Him is the return. And the mushrikun, they mocked at the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They spoke ill of him, and they mocked him. And they said, look, look at this man who claims to be a prophet. Yet, he doesn't have any sons. Look at the messenger whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who they claim that Allah sent. Look at him. From them is Al-As ibn Wa'il, who said, as mentioned in Tafsir ibn Kathir, he said, da'u, leave him, abandon him. فَإِنَّهُ رَجُلٌ أَبْتَرٌ. For he's a man that is cut off from blessings, cut off from lineage. This is what they claimed about the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, لاق عاقب له فإذا هلك انقطع ذكره. There is no lineage that would follow him. So when he dies, then his remembrance will be forgotten about. عليه الصلاة والسلام. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defended the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إنك فيناك المستهزئين. We will suffice you over the mockers. We will suffice you over those who mock at you and belittle you and look down at you, and speak ill of you, and insult you, and call your names, and scoff at you. We will defend you. And Allah subhanahu wa defended the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he aided him in his life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised him, for indeed Allah azza wa jal raised his rank. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. And we have raised your remembrance. Subhanallah. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, wa ala ali Muhammad. كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إِنَّكَ حَمِيدٌ مَجِيدٌ. The most compassionate, the most merciful of mankind, the best in manners, the best in etiquette, the best in guidance. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his name is continued to be remembered. His name continues to continue to lead and guide and lead billions of people around the world. And those who hear of his statements and hear of his actions and his beautiful manner and his exemplary manners, they know the status of this man. He's not like any other man. He is the best of creation, alayhi salatu wassalam. And Allah raised his rank. Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar, fasalli li rabbika wanhar. So pray to your Lord and sacrifice. Pray to your Lord, the best qurbah, the best closeness that you can get to Allah is you turn to prayer. Pray and it's time. أَيُّ عَمَلٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ قَالَ الصَّلَاةُ فِي وَقْتِهَا. Which action is most beloved to Allah? He said, prayer and it's time. Beloved to Allah. And Allah mentioned the sacrifice of sacrificing a sacrificial animal with the salah. To show you that this dabh, this is a great act of worship. A great act of worship, for indeed, you do it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't do it. You don't do it just to spill the blood or to sacrifice the animal. You do it for Allah because it's not the blood that reaches Allah. It's not the meat that reaches Allah. But it's your taqwa. لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهِ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. That is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from each and every one of us. It's taqwa from us. Piety, that we come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a pure heart, and yet there are amongst them. In the Muslim countries, you'll find those who sacrifice to other than Allah. They go to the graves and they sacrifice a sheep or whatever it is, and they do that getting closer to the dead or getting closer to somebody they claim to be pious. This is not what Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he would sacrifice, said, Bismillah, Allahu Akbar. He would say the takbir, and it would be for Allah alone, not for anyone else. فَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهَا. And mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon it. And Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he said, from that he's saying, Allahu Akbar, Allahumma minka walaka. Oh Allah, this is from you and for you. For your sake, a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from the manners of sacrificing the sacrificial animal, the sheep, or the cow, or the camel. Seven can share the cow or camel, as the scholars have mentioned. And with the sheep, they sacrifice a sheep that is a year old, or 6 months, as some of the scholars mentioned, a year old, and they, or 2 years, and they turn it towards the Qibla. They turn it towards the Qibla. They don't sacrifice it in front of other sheep. This is from the adab and from the manners. They don't show it the knife. This is from the adab and the manners. And they say, Bismillah, Allahu Akbar. They follow the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. So pray to your Lord and sacrifice. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on these days, he sacrificed 63 camels. In this day of Eid, he sacrificed 63 camels. And he finished all of the 4 great acts of worship, whether it is Rami al-Jamrat al-Aqaba, which is the first of the things that they do, and the Nahar, which is the sacrifice, and the Halq, which is the shaving, which is better than the cutting of the hair for the people doing Hajj, and the Tawaf and the Sa'i, Tawaf al-Ifada with Sa'i. He did all of that before Dhuhr. Imagine how blessed his time was. He did all of those acts of worship before Dhuhr. And those who go for Hajj, you will see. If you finish before Maghrib, it's a blessing. But the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam finished before Salat al-Dhuhr. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who benefit from these days. These blessed days of the 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. Striving to do all those things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us with. Keeping up our prayers. Or whether we're doing voluntary fasts. And no doubt, the great voluntary fast which is coming on Monday. Because the day of Eid is going to be Tuesday, inshallah. And Monday will be Yawm Arafah, that great standing. Those who will be in Arafah, whether they're standing or sitting, that great act of worship of making dua to Allah. And for you and me who are not in Hajj, Allah has not left us. He gave us fasting. And you will get 2 years of sins removed. The previous year and the forthcoming year. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala benefit us in these days. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. From those who will come to the pool, we mention, will be those who will be rejected. And there's an authentic narration in Tabrani mentions it in Al-Awsat. And Shaykh Al-Bani rahmahullah mentioned in Silsat Ahadith Sahiha. He said, alayhi salatu wasalam, sinfan min ummati, la yaridani al-hawd, wa la yadkhulani al-jannah. Two types of people from my ummah, they will not be accepted from coming to the pool. And nor will they be accepted in entering paradise. And the scholars mention in the first instance. And that is the Murji'a and the Qadariya, he said. So he mentioned these by name. Those who reject and deny the Qadr. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows an action before it happens. He knows everything subhanahu wa ta'ala. They deny this. Until the person does the action, then they say Allah came to know. And this is batil. This is the belief of the Qadariya, this group, this sect, who went astray. And the Murji'a who don't believe that actions are from Iman. They don't believe that actions are from Iman. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself said, أُدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Enter paradise with your actions that you used to do. Actions are from the usul Iman. Iman is statement of the tongue. Belief in the heart and actions of the limbs. It increases with the obedience to Allah and decreases with disobedience to Allah. So this hadith clearly shows us that in the first instance, those who had innovation, who had bid'ah, and rejected that which the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or left that which the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam called to, in those important aspects of the deen, then they will not drink from the hawd. This is clear proof. And how about those then who speak ill of Sahaba, who refute the Sahaba, who have vile speech about the companions? How will they be able to drink from the hawd? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who love the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and defend the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Allah defended him. إِنَّ عَطَيْنَاكَ الْكَوْثَرِ فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ إِنَّ شَانِئَكَ هُوَ الْأَبْتَرِ. And this verse, إِنَّ شَانِئَكَ هُوَ الْأَبْتَرِ, the ones who were speaking all ill of you, the ones who insulted you, they're the ones who are cut off from blessings, cut off of lineage, they're the ones cut off from all good, for they're the ones who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished, the likes of Abu Lahab and other than him, and those who insulted the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like the ones we mentioned. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who strive in these days, whether it is giving extra charity, fasting, or prayers and extra voluntary prayers, ties of kinship, being kind to our parents, helping those who are in need, helping those relatives around us, and likewise keeping good brotherhood in our community. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive those who have passed away amongst our families. Allahumma aghfir lahum warhamhum. وعافيهم وعفو عنهم وأكرم نزلهم ووسع مدخلهم وابدلهم دارا خيرا من دارهم وأهلا خيرا من أهلهم. اللهم نقي خطاياهم كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس واغسل خطاياهم بماء الثلج والبرد. اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم واغفر لنا وتب علينا. May Allah forgive us and our children. May Allah guide our children to keep their identity, to be upon Tawheed and Sunnah, to be Muslims, to practice it, and to be upon this blessed path until death reaches us. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka Hamidum Majid wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka Hamidum Majid. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al mursalin walhamdulillahi bil alamin.